though. We'll definitely see it in the game. Well, I think one important thing that we're going to see is this kind of little dance between the two sides, especially on the CT. If Titans start off, even if Ninjas in Pyjamas start off on the CT, we'll see a lot of these pushes down Banana for map control and for information. One of the plays that Ninjas in Pyjamas like to do is they like to have one in B and one supporting at Speedway. He'll throw that smoke in early smoke and flash, and then after that, he'll just back away in Speedway just to support bombsite A. So
it's Stefano versus Naniwa, StarCraft 2 micro battles.
Right click.
Who's winning? Oh, it's actually Naniwa who wins this one. I mean, it's the first Swedish StarCraft player I could think of that was famous. So there you go.
Well, but you know more StarCraft players than I do, that's for sure.
How many StarCraft players do you know?
I know quite a few. I know most of the guys who switch from Warcraft, because I used to watch a lot of Warcraft 3, so I know all the like Grubby and the crew from Warcraft 3.
This smoke, by the way, is awesome. Look, he's practicing.
This is a new smoke, by the way. This is a smoke really that didn't exist before. That, well, you know what was happening? One of the CTs would actually go all the way to B to throw the smoke, and then he'd run all the way back. But now they're able to throw it from CT spawn, which is really good.
Here we go. NIP. Titan, we're getting live into the first half here. Well, map number two, of course, it is
going to be a
match
game.
Point here for NIP. If they take down Inferno, they are knocking out Titan from the tournament and moving on to the semi-finals, where they might possibly face Hellraisers, who are looking pretty strong. They haven't finished their match yet, but we'll see in the future. And we are expecting to see some long-range pistol duels to start with from NIP. That's what they want. But in fact, actually, look, yeah, they're going to go for this, but not on mid, which is often denied by a smoke. Instead, they're actually sitting back all together on pit. And look at these jumps by Kenny. Again, the parkouring French players here, they know how to move. And this, I like this. This is a new
three
setup.
Man pit.
This is a new setup. This is really nice, but it's not going to get much use. And actually, the challenge is going to be on the B bombsite.
257s as well. And they've paid a lot of money
to win
the pistol
angle.
Round. They've got 257s, one in bombsite A and one in bombsite B.
Here they go.
It's going to be a bombsite B execute here. Freiberg. Anything with the USB. Is he going to throw that nade? Is it going to be effective? Well, quite a lot of damage on Kenny. Yes, he gets dinked pretty hard. He will be able to take down. Actually, that's Get Right taking down Smiths as he tries to plant the bomb in the smoke. He hears it. Using the sound for his advantage. And they're holding them off at least for long enough for the auxiliary forces to come and support. Well, actually, not long enough indeed. The back of the bomb is going to be
one frag as well.
Yep, only one frag. Actually, I expected Get Right to do a bit more damage with that 5-7. He had the gun advantage, but Exist will be able to take down MBK now. It's 3-on-3. Kenny S only with 5 HP. Is he going to be able to do any damage? Forrest jumping through, has no idea there's somebody in CT spawn. Pulled through, go through the courtyard. He doesn't care. Scream gets a kill on Fifth Laren. Forrest is pushing through, takes down Scream. Now it's back to a 2-on-2. Kenny S with 1 HP. Existence taking down Exist. And now it's all up to Forrest. He'll take down one person, but I don't think he'll have enough time to defuse the bomb. Maybe enough time to take down Exist.
He's gonna go for it.
Oh, he actually had a defuse kit as well. He could have definitely gone for that hold, but sadly, well, for Titans' benefit, Existence was there to stop it. Good job there by Titan to take the bomb site and to defend it successfully against the marauding Swedes. Very close there. Get Right perhaps could have done a better job with the 5-7, but with that many flashes and smokes around, it's very, very difficult indeed.
And here we go. Get Right is going to probably
look at this buy.
He's got the floater roll here, so he can actually just go back. They leave Freiberg on B bomb site. He's got, because if you can play that smoke that we talked about earlier, if you've got a really strong player on that site, like your Neos or your Freibergs. That's how that works. And it's a hard roll to do. Freiberg goes down though, but he only had a pistol. Bless him.
Well, we had a 5-7, not just any pistol, my friend. Bless him.
It's the Ferrari of pistols.
Yeah, it is. It's the Ducati of pistols, as Simi says. Well, not really the Ducati. I think the Ducati is more like the... Well, I don't know. What would the Ducati
I don't
be
know.
Guns?
I don't know.
It'd be the AK-47.
I'm out of my
debt.
Cars, bikes, I'm out of my debt.
It'd be the AK. You're not going to say anything. Well, I guess at the moment, they've given away control of the bomb site. The bomb's been planted, and I think the best choice for them is to try and save the 5-7s and armor and to keep... Perhaps get one or two kills on the T side.
Yeah, this is really the thing. If you can make two frags out of this, boom, you're done. And we actually see that, we had the pistol armor. They actually want to keep hold of the armor for the next round. So the save is really, really good. I mean, there's four of them. So just save it.
This is a good save here. This is a good save here by Ninjas in Pyjamas. It's not bad at all, actually, because they can play another round with the 5-7s and armor without actually using up a lot of money, or any money, in fact. Freiberg probably not even going to buy anything. Keep the money for the next round. So full armor and 5-7s again. Try two. Let's see if this time it's going to work for them, as we see a four-man stack here in bomb site B. Only one person in eight. It's the switch. And Existence, is he reading the CT game properly, or is he just making lucky calls at the moment as they push towards the lone man in bomb site A? Fifflarion's got a good angle here. Will he be able to make the shot? He's got his first one. Right place, but Scream's going to crouch just before he checks the angle. Goodness me, did you see that flurry of nades? All of a sudden, now the CTs are going to try to quickly retake the site. Terrorists at the moment don't know that it's completely empty. They're going to be faced with a barrage of CTs coming in from bomb site B. They have to be very careful. Nice Molotov there, but just a tad bit late. And they have to use the long distance there advantage. MBK dying, giving away the Galil to Forest. It's not something you want to do. Don't give them more firepower than they have. These guys are beasts without it. Smiths on 1 HP.
Forest causing some trouble with the Galil.
Yep.
This is dangerous here, actually, because if he can just get a couple of frags, he's already got two players very low. This can get really hairy very quickly there for this French side of Titan, but it's taking a little bit too long. Forrest might opt to save this. He's already got the head armor still. Oh yeah, he wants to fall back right now, surely. Is he going to go for some more frags? They're already locked in. The bomb's probably already going to finish them off at this point. He's just going to go in for another sneaky frag.
Just by a second. Barely. He's not going to be able to get another frag. Kenny S and Exist, the only people surviving the radius of that bomb blast. But very good there by Forrest, actually. Picked up the gun and caused a bit of havoc.
It's actually, I was thinking Misha safe, but actually it makes more sense because he would have had to have, because he wouldn't have gotten money afterwards, he would have had to rebuy anyway. Now he gets into the Galil and he gets to play with his M4, so it's actually,
It's better.
Didn't make a difference. It would have been nicer to get some more money from the frag. So.
But I mean, everyone died except for Kenny S, so that's really good for them. Kenny S didn't even have a gun. Interesting Molotov
there. What happened
there?
That was quite strange.
I don't know.
But they are taking over apartments here, getting the map control. And I like how Getright and Freiburg are going the middle of the road route here by getting... They're not going for the deep smoke, but they're going for the partial deny here, the middle ground. Yep. They're keeping this ground on the car and sandbags, allowing them to, have more pressure, deny more from Titan. And they have to do this. You cannot really let Titan just take banana. You can't just let them have full map control and have full options. You have to try to throw a wrench in the works and apply pressure and be proactive to get the information. That's what they're doing. NIP know what they're doing for certain. And Old Forest over the smoke. Great little position here. Will they be able to spot this in time?
Oh, he gets flashed though. He has to change his position. We'll get a kill before going down. Exist is going to pop out at the right moment. Good little bit of teamwork as he gets himself a triple. Exist. Distance MBK and Kenny S going down to his M4. Very nice job there by Exist. And a good round by Ninjas in Pajamas in their first buy round. 3-1 for Titan, but Ninjas in Pajamas providing us proof as to how dangerous they can be on those buy rounds. And look at Exist, 5 kills to 1 death. He's only died once in the last 4 rounds, even though they've lost 3. So they've been really looking after their economy very well. Good smoke there.
I love it.
This is a smoke that you see Ninjas in Pajamas play a lot. In front of the car, they actually take the more narrow angle.
Yep,
they don't play deeper. And that's pretty cool. Very, very cool indeed.
It's the... I mean, you have the three locations you have here. You have the deep one, and you have the very defensive one. They go for the middle of the road one, and I think that's the safest but most proactive one. It's really, I think, one of the better ones with the least risks. And I love how they are doing this. And we're seeing kind of the
pop flash
the
ready
pop
for
flash
action.
Indeed.
Yeah.
And they need to do this. They need to get some info on Banana because stuff is happening now. They've got to get those flanks in the works right now because Titan are going to be making a move. And this is a really big round. We can see not a full buy from Titan. If they manage to actually win this round against NIP, they're going to screw their money and completely. And there they go in, flooding from the balcony, from that house. And Fifflarion with that spray down. 2 frags from the AK. Smith to take him down from the side, but he is done.
Great movement there by Smith. Oh my goodness, almost a triple kill for him, but not enough bullets on that CZ.
That's always the thing, isn't it? It's pretty good. So, there's only 24 bullets.
Yeah. It's only even 12 before you have to reload. But interesting, you see that nade actually stopping the push, not because of the damage, but because it literally physically stopped them from running through.
I hate that. It's so annoying.
And it's really annoying. It must be annoying once you're pushing in through apartments for a small little nade to like physically stop you from running.
Yeah, I know.
And
it's like you think that your body weight would be able to
bounce it off. I mean, it's not that heavy, is it? But for Fifflarion getting that double kill, very nice spray down, and Forrest missing 2 shots here on mid.
It's a good point. It's almost like tackling a rugby player. It's a small little grenade, isn't it? This is like completely stops you.
Doesn't make any sense.
It's crazy. These physics, man, it's not realistic.
Maybe that's something they need to fix on the next update. We have Exist holding outside as usual. Forrest moved all the way back to the graveyard. McLaren at truck side. Looks like the echoing terrorists will be pushing in through mid.
So all smokes used by ninjas in pajamas now. They've fallen back into the very, very most defensive lines. There's nowhere else to fall back to. But you can see this line right here. And they're going to go for it right now. And they're actually pushing back NIP some more. NIP are just letting them do this. Just keeping the ranges as long as possible. Because they got those pistols. And oh, just barely taking down MBK there. But there's still more French players just charging in there. And so they will lose a couple of men. This is not looking good. Kenny S just found himself an AWP.
He's so good with a CZ. Goodness me. That's three kills for him. And this is a huge eco here for the terrorist side. Picking up an AWP, taking down four players. And if Freiburg doesn't do something very substantial and very amazing, it's going to be an eco win for Titan on Inferno as the terrorist side. Disastrous for the Swedes, who did not see that coming. And that really aggressive, proactive play here by the terrorists really worked out for them. Pushing through, going to the arch, going through library, wrapping around the CTs. They didn't see what was coming at all. And those smokes actually worked as a disadvantage for the CTs more than an advantage. Freiburg here, firing in all directions, spreading his damage across three Frenchmen. It's not enough to kill one. Gonna take down Scream at least. He's gonna try and go for the defuse. Goodness me. Yes, he's going to catch sight of him, and he's going to miss two shots. Freiburg will actually be able to get existence. Will Kenny save the AWP? At least, no!
Yeah.
That is, well, it is an eco win, but still.
But yeah, Kenny S, you can see him shaking his mouse there. That was a bit of frustration coming out. He missed two shots, which by Kenny S's standards are extremely easy to hit. It should be guaranteed. So Kenny S, you know, he can't be calling himself into question here. And things like that can, you know, maybe start to do that, can start to shake your confidence. Mm. And that's why playing in a team can be so important sometimes. You get the benefit of your teammates, you know, their morale, they keep your spirits high, that, you know, you watch them play good, you feel good. And, you know, I don't think expect Kenny to be doubting himself. Look at this, picking up the AK, going for this very mobile play. Is what we need to see here, but they can't quite break into mid just yet. The far massive exist is looking pretty good.
They're just going for the peaks right now. One on one. Aim action. No flashes and smokes at the moment. It's putting out the sign as they push in through. Get right's going to be waiting for them on arch side. Nice little peek there to attract get right shots. Pre fire by the Swede. We'll bag him a kill on Smiths. Now we have three terrorists remaining against four. MBK taking down Freiburg, equalizing the chances. It's 3-on-3 with nobody here in bombsite B. If MBK is able to, well, actually, I thought he was going to push through to CT spawn. He's going to throw down that smoke and sit tight and wait for the CT to come back. Getting better off get right. This is excellent play here by MBK. It's 2-on-2 right now. Existing for Flaren, trying to retake the bombsite. Wow, Exist taking down MBK from quite a distance here. Through the truck. And now it's all up to Kenny S. Kenny S has to be very careful. His position here is not the best one, but he will get the better of Exist. Come up from behind, and there's a fast defuse here by Fifflaren. Maybe that's a mistake here by Fifflaren, but he'll get the headshot on Kenny S, and that's a huge round for Ninjas in Pajamas. But will the bomb explode? No, it won't.
So close.
Great defuse here by Fifflaren. And it was good that Fifflaren actually did that. That aggressive defuse forced Kenny S out of his hole. Kenny S saw him go through, so Kenny S knew that he was going to try and defuse. And that made it so that Fifflaren could have a one-on-one with Kenny S without him thinking, is Kenny S going to hop out from a different angle?
Yeah, it's one of those spots where, you know, you kind of just... I mean, it's just one of those spots. You don't want to risk the guy just holding. And that's been happening more and more lately. It's hard to... It's one of those things you don't really want to say, oh, well, in the meta game, people usually do this. You should just peek. You just want to get a quick, you know, quick glimpse to see, you know, what's actually happening. Because that's a really good spot to play with. And Kenny S, he's quite monstrous with that AK. I'm really surprised. It really looked like he had it under control. So good stuff from Kenny. And they are working mid. And get right in Freiburg. They're still just playing their standard banana, middle of the road smoke to get that control. And Titan, meanwhile, taken mid and A by Storm.
Very aggressive push here by Smiths. Fires away on Exist, puts him to 26 HP, and ends up finishing off Fifflaren as Freiburg comes to support. Very fast here by Freiburg. We've got some fast-paced Counter-Strike. Forest doing quite a bit of damage with that mag, but not enough. This is a really, really close game indeed between these two titans, or these two monsters of Counter-Strike, as MBK will get a sharp shot here on Exist, but get right with the Mag 7. He's the last man standing here for the CT side. Picks up the Galil. Doesn't have enough time to go for the defuse, and he'll get finished off by Kenny S anyway. Another kill for him, though. That hurts the economy of the T side just a little bit more.
So let's take stock then and see, of course, both teams, you know, not really looking good on the money situation. Both, they've been, you know, going blow for blow so often when it comes to getting those frags that neither team can really establish something that looks, you know, like a burgeoning and growing economy. So let's see now if Titan or NIP are able to make efforts towards that. Of course, we're seeing, you know, the eco coming in from NIP here, just, you know, a couple CZs, and otherwise a complete full eco coming in from them. And they are grouping up here. I love this play on mid. The stack there can sometimes be really deadly. All peeking out now, but all into screams. Spray
That's
down.
The scream we want to see.
And it's just Freiburg here now. So there you go. Fairly easy cleanup. And it's one more player to take down. He has a CZ75 in his hands. So take care. But other than that,
they
should be all right. And Titan are going to be moving into a stronger and stronger economy. And you know, they've been doing so well with the mobile Kenny S with that AK these days. You know, you don't really want to play an AWP on the T side on an Inferno. The mobility is just such an issue. And 6-3, the score there for Titan as we move forwards. And NIP are going to have to find some answers here. Perhaps Get Right is going to start leaving Freiburg alone. You know, throwing that smoke from the position we talked about before, and just letting Freiburg be a bit solo, because they haven't really been testing B at all. It's all been about these mid plays and these A plays. And so let's see how this goes right now. They're playing a bit more defensively, actually.
It's going to fall by here. Very deep play by on the bomb B bomb site, but it's quite close to the mid on A. The Flaren actually changing direction, giving away truck site. Well, that's because he boosted up Forest. Is going to be holding it with Exist. Four men! Three men. Bombsite A. Two in bombsite B. Got a bit of a mind right there as I thought there was a CT holding apartments, but that's why Flaren's looking to that direction. T's are getting ready for a push into bombsite A. They do have one man marauding over there. Doris does see them. Is he going to fire straight away? Well, he's going to give away his position. They know he's on top of quad now. Nice nade, which will really, really hurt Forest. Good smoke there by the T's. They're going to keep the CTs guessing. NES getting a kill on Forest. Exist before being terminated. We'll be able to take out Smithson. Existence has been playing very well for his side. As the in-game leader for the Titan team, he's really proving why that stereotype about in-game leaders not getting frags is untrue. Freiburg now, again, the last man standing. It's 4-on-1. And Titan are really getting the confidence going. They're getting into their game. And on this T side, 7-3, this is looking pretty bad here for Ninjas and Pajamas as Titan slowly build momentum towards the victory.
And now, now it's going to be really cool to just watch in the way in which they use Kenny S, because, of course, you know, he picked up that AWP. So what are they going to do with it? Because he's one of those players that is probably the best player when it comes to just keeping mobility with what is otherwise an immobile weapon. So I'm really curious to see how he plays with this. We saw him pushing mid with his teammates there, almost as if he had an AK last round. So
yep.
So love to see more of that, as they have found so much success going in, you know, to start rounds with mid. Oh, oh. And they dink him. They are playing aggressively with the pistols. They're going to hear that dig on Kenny S. They want him. They just want the AWP's blood right now, and Kenny S is just, he's just hiding. He's not going to take this for granted.
If they had a nade. If only they had a nade right there. They must be cursing themselves. But that's really interesting. Kenny S has to be careful not to play so aggressive with the AWP, because you don't want to give the AWP to an ecoing side. You don't want to give them that firepower by being too aggressive with the AWP. However, they have to take it easy. They cannot underestimate the Ninjas and Pajamas side. Titan have won an eco round before. Ninjas and Pajamas can definitely win it this game as well. And they have to take it easy. But it looks pretty clean for them. And for the last three rounds, they've only lost a maximum of one player from their side. So they are looking a lot more solid as we go on, even on a bye round. That's very, very good news here for Titan. As MBK will take down Get Right, last man standing is at one site B, and he'll be finished off by MBK. And if we check the scores, we can take a look and see who's doing well and who isn't. In general, it seems like the Titan side is very balanced. We have 10 kills on Kenny S. Scream actually picking up the game with 9. MBK with 10. And Smith's in existence with 6-5. On the other hand, Exist, the only person who's really keeping Ninjas and Pajamas in the game at the moment with 11 kills. But it's not about the amount of kills. It's about the importance of them.
Yeah, I mean, they've mostly been working mid-middle. We're not really seeing Freiburg with much action. You know, Get Right, the floater, has been, you know, trying to try and salvage some of the lost defenses going on over at mid. And so far, you know, because we don't see any kind of pressure from NIP, that they're kind of playing very reactively and not, I don't think they're pushing enough, and they're not, we're not seeing an AWP from them on mid, we're not seeing any peaks or anything like that. Mm-hmm. You know, they just let themselves get smoked out, they slowly fall back to more and more defensive lines. You know, we're seeing, you know, close to what is the most defensive line here, all the way back, because they just get smoked out and naded out. It's almost as if, you know, Titan are playing very, 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 very good Inferno fundamentals right now on the T side, and so far that just seems to be enough for them to actually pull the victory out here, or at least on this first half, because they are doing really well, and so far, if it ain't broke, don't fix it, and they're sticking to that, and we're seeing all the smokes going down here. You can see their movement through mid, and actually Scream taking a crazy shot there from apartments onto graveyard, and this is going to be confusing for NIP now, because they feel really, really vulnerable on the A-bomb site. But Titan are all over CT spawn as well. They can do anything they want, and they've got a player trying to make his way in on B. They have so many options. Kenny, S. You just cannot fault the man.
And the thing is, at the moment, you can see that NIP is slowly losing the confidence that they had earlier on after winning the first map. And you can see they're backing away, and they're giving way too much room for Titan to play their game. They're not pushing them at mid. They're not pushing them at banana like they were earlier on in the game. And they're giving up too much room. And right now, it's just them trying to retake bomb sites again and again. And they're not doing enough damage every round. The economy of the T side is just getting stronger and stronger here. And they're getting more and more confident. This is the closest they've been to winning, with two deaths for the T side, and they're going to have to go for an eco. Frymeg and Getright are going to save their guns to fight another day. However, we have news from the other matches. We've found out that Hellraisers are actually having a hard time versus SK Gaming on Nuke. It's currently 9-8 for Hellraisers. It's an interesting game going on there. I wonder what will happen.
I swear, you know, Kenny has some of the stuff that he does. It's not PG. You need to hide your kids.
But, hide your kids, hide your wife.
Kenny S is just is explicit with that AWP, doing very crazy things. 9-3 on the terrorist side so far. Ninjas with yet to find an answer. And okay, finally we're getting to see the smoke going in from Get Right. But actually, is he going to go to B now? Which is kind of a bit of cognitive dissonance there, because he could have just gone to B quickly and made the same smoke anyway.
I think maybe it was a call hit by Fiverr, as he saw the nades come through. The thing is, the T side have not been pushing B unless they get a frag. Unless MBK goes there and gets a first frag, then they push B. They don't push B together at the same time, and this is clever by them. Oh, very clever by Titan.
And now they're playing ninjas again. They're just saying, look, we're over at banana, we're over at banana, when really, again, they're just going for the mid plays again. And Kenny S gets another kill in mid, whilst Get Right and Freiburg are messing around in banana, when they really need Get Right to be helping them, when they need more firepower over towards middle. And that is always the endeavor of the French side, Titan. As the ninjas, again, very defensive lines here on the A-bomb site once more. And Freiburg might be seeing some action here. And he does indeed pick up a kill onto MBK. Important stuff there. And there goes a little pop flash to you know, ensure his safety. But again,
oh, Get Right with a kill. And this doesn't look very good here for Titan, who only have two men remaining. It's Kenny S and Existence. Kenny S getting tagged pretty badly by Get Right. One thing we've noticed is MBK marauding around has been kind of the key to the Titan offense. MBK getting those kills, entry fragging into bombsite B. But it looks like this is a good choice here by Existence. There's only one person in bombsite B. That's Freiburg. He throws in the Molotov to take him out, but he won't be able to get the kill. And only 10 seconds on the clock, they had to push in and they were destroyed. 9-4 for Titan. It wasn't a round they will lose much losing, but it was very important for Ninjas in Pyjamas to keep in the game and to stop the momentum rising for the Frenchman.
It was a good read from Ninjas in Pyjamas, because they need Get Right over towards A. He was providing the support there that really stopped the push, because, you know, they've been typically relying on, you know, Fifth and Forest towards Quad, and of course Exists on CC Arch. You know, their Get Right, he wasn't needed at banana. Most of the time he's not needed at banana. Titan have been, you know, keeping them there, because it's, I think, how did Devilwalk put it? It's the it's that the threat is worse than the execution. The threat is more important than the execution. Yeah. There. So, you know, they're threatened thinking that if it could be B, then if a B execute actually came. Yep. There. And so just leave Freiburg there, let him do his thing after a while, and get right onto A for some more support. Seems to be, you know, pretty good on the last round. This round again, you know, they're playing it very, very safe.
Yeah, it was the Freiburg versus MBK, and Freiburg got the better of MBK, and that kind of really went towards Titan's side. It's still 5-on-5 with 45 seconds on the clock. It's a beautiful dance between these masters of Counter-Strike as they both attempt to find the weakness in their opponent's defense. Forrest with the first kill on Smiths. Good not play here. Looking right through that smoke. Well, that little gap in the smoke as Get Right is going to be ready for. I do believe it's MBK pushing into the bomb site. Doesn't have a lot of HP on him. Only 8 MBK is between a rock and a hard place as he has 2 Ninjas in Pajamas players. Easing right onto him. Exist will finish him off. And it looks like the T's will be rotating towards bomb site B. One person coming in from arch side, the other two coming in from Banana. Kenny S missing his shot. Scream with a headshot on Get Right. Exist returning the favor. Now it's Existence. He has the bomb. He has the bomb site. If he's able to plant it, that's a good economic advantage. If he's able to win a round, it's even better. Existence against Forrest and Fiflarin. Will the tactics genius himself be able to use his brain to survive this round? Oh, will the Warriors of Nip be able to get the better of him? Very close there. Forrest forced onto 9 HP, but it will be a bomb defuse for Ninjas in Pajamas, and they'll make it 9-5. Now the score is looking a bit more realistic.
What a relief. What a relief. I mean, you know, 6-9, you know, they can work from that. But if it was going to be something like 11-4 or, you know, something similar to that, that is just, you just don't want that on Inferno. That is really a hard climb to make. And you can see Forrest making the banana smoke there for his 2 teammates. And interesting. Nip really do like that smoke. And look at the nades going down for the aggressive play on banana. And Forrest is going to find some action, but Kenny S. Oh, the no-scope double. There it comes. Kenny S making his way on quad. And Titan have put up the French flag on the A bomb site here. There is just no quarters right now, and Ninjas are having to go for the retake play. This is going to be tough because they have basically their ideal post-plant setup here. But Kenny S over at quad watching from CT Arch. Anyone coming around? They have all 5 left alive. Yes, we'll fall back there. So hard to push through that smoke, and it's been working graveyard. They've got such good positions, and it's going to be so difficult. Frybing and Get Right.
Almost a flawless T round here by Titan as they get control and keep control of the bomb site. Frybing getting shot down. It's 10-5. Titan are 5 rounds ahead of Ninjas in Pajamas in the first half of this game on Inferno. And this is very, very interesting indeed.
That was really unlucky for them because it was the first round where they decided to go, let's do a 3-man push down Banana when Titan were going a heavy, like hard-hitting
very, very
A
fast
push.
A push. Yeah. It was just a bad call in the poor time. I'd win this little 5 seconds that we have. I'd like to give a special thanks to the DreamHack stream that made it possible for us to broadcast this great match. Steel Series for being the main sponsor of the event, and also for Need for Seat. As their name suggests, they do make better seats for offices and gaming, so do check them out. Obviously, the biggest thanks goes to all of you guys that have been watching the stream from me and from DDK. You can show us some love and come register and play some CSGO on www.vasit.com and try out our sleek matchmaking system. So hit the follow button if you're liking the cast. We really, really appreciate that. Thank you. Thank you very, very much for watching. And it's going to be the second half of this scintillating match. We are hoping for Titan to win so that we can see a third match between these two teams. But I'm sure the Ninjas in Pajamas fans and also the Nip players themselves are probably trying, most likely going to disagree with me.
And I saw Scoots in the chat there saying he's going to come down to London in August. So we'll see you there. And we can go for a drink there, and Scoots can impart his knowledge. And
why do you have to come in August? But why can't he come when like I'm here? Why can't he come now?
I don't know. He's a busy man. He's a busy man.
I can imagine.
Either way, it's going to be quite interesting to see how the second half goes. There's a lot of pressure on NIP here to really pull out something special on the aggressive side. And I don't know. I'm doubting it right now. I'm really doubting it. Titan look really on top of things. And the thing is that I would expect Titan to have actually a stronger CT side as well, because their CT, their defenses, they know the map so well. And they've got Kenny S now, who is just a monster when it comes to like blowing up T plays before they can get started, because he's got so many little quick picks. Like just to explain, like some of the types of things he does, like he was kind of pioneering this one of these little aggressive moves where he gets a good spawn for mid. He has a smoke in his hand with the AWP as well. And he's running. He throws a smoke. It pops just before he gets on the mid angle. Then he's up in the window and then pops someone off like with a quick flick shot from who's down in second mid, and then falls back. And it's like, what do you do? And
Exactly.
You know, he does all the apartments pushes, the aggressive warping in apartments. Yep. He does the aggressive warping in Banana. He's everywhere.
He's so important.
Yep.
As we take a look at the brackets, Nip Gaming is one. Titan, perhaps, will make it a draw. But at the moment, Hellraisers are ahead of SK Gaming, 13-10 on Nuke. So it's not looking too great for the Swedish scene at the moment. However, Ninjas in Pajamas ready to continue with the hope and to allow the Swedish tournament to have a Swedish victor. We'll wait and see on Inferno. But as you were saying, Kenny S was doing an excellent job playing with that aggressive AWP. And I think that once the other players on the team picked up the pace as well, once we saw some really important entry frags there by MBK, once we saw Scream with a few kills, especially on the eco rounds, trying getting his confidence up and getting those really important shots pushing in, those entry frags really gave Titan the power to win those really important rounds. It was the pure entry frag power of MBK and Scream and even Existence in those clutch situations. So we're going to hop back into the game. It's started in the second half, and a very interesting second half it will be for sure. There is no doubt about that, as Titan will be five rounds ahead. And they'll be playing on the CT side. Nice nade there on Get Right, but doesn't do quite any damage, actually.
Yeah, and I like how they're playing this LMP. They're going for a bit of a slow apartments take. And that's nice, keep the Rangers close and see how things go from there. Because, again, you can read a situation that you can say the counter-terrorist side, it's very unlikely for them to be in apartments because those are bad engagements for them, pistol versus pistol. So they're going for what is more or less a sure thing here. They just have to execute here. Look at the grenades coming and spilling into the site. And MBK is a really big man to take down for them. Existence on Graveyard as well. These positions, they're holding them, Titan. They're doing a wonderful job. This is just... oh my goodness.
MBK did an excellent job not chasing the terrorists after he watched, after he saw them go through. He was flashed, but he knew that they jumped through. He stayed in his spot, and he he just wished for the best. But they were able to stop that push into bomb site A, only losing MBK and a bit of health on Kenny S. Now it's all up to Fifflaren, who has a pretty, pretty tough...
yeah, this is beyond tough.
it's a very tough mission.
This is running a marathon with no legs.
You can't run though, can you?
Exactly. It's impossible. But can Fifflaren?
Well, he can do something here.
He do it?
He got the first kill. He's got 10 seconds left on the clock. Did quite a bit of damage on Scream. If he rushes through right now, he can really hurt them. They have to hide. They know he can't plant the bomb. Well, Scream will finish him off anyway. But Fifflaren actually doing an admirable job at Pit. It was a last stand. It was like one of those movies where they fight off hundreds and hundreds of soldiers on their own with machine guns. Like kind of like Rambo.
Now it's, if you look at this, the situation for Titan now, oh my goodness, they are in a lot of trouble on the Ninjas. They're looking at going down, maybe 13 rounds to 5, almost the game over already. They went for pistol armor because, and they didn't actually get head armor. They opted for nades instead of the extra armor, the extra bit of money for the head armor. And this is, of course, because they didn't get a plant, and they have to double eco anyway. So this is the reason why they go for the buy here. It's just a win-win for them. And let's see what they can do with this. They're going for the B play, and I'm sure that the man holding the Molotov, look at Forrest here. Let's see if we can... yeah, we're going all the way to the back of the site here. So they know they don't have to check the new boxes there. And in they go. This is going really well. I like this play a lot from Ninjas.
Very aggressive player. They weren't able... Smiths and Scream weren't able to... hold them off. They didn't even do that much damage. So that's two FAMASes for them. Kenny S in Existence and MBK now have to try and retake the bombsite from four terrorists. Get Right will be the first victim. Forrest will take down Kenny S, who is cheekily coming in from the courtyard. They've got good positions, the terrorist players at the moment. Forrest actually able to get around MBK. It's up to Existence now, as his M4. Is he just going to go for the save? It looks like it is running away from the scene of the crime, Existence, saving that M4 for another day. And I think that's a good choice by him.
So, this is the strongest pistol armor play I've ever seen from any team on Inferno. Because it's just, it's a very powerful play. If you have the right nades behind it, if we just go back to the site. Oh, we just came from Scream, so look at the camera. It's like, POV is bugged, I think, but so it's all slanted. But either way, you get the Molotov back here, and of course a smoke down here, and you're running in with pistols. You're against two players, and you got armor, so they have to really hit you in the head to get the quick kill on you. So and with FAMASes and stuff, that's not easy to do necessarily. So you're probably gonna get more body shots than not. So it's a really strong play with pistols. I love that from Ninjas in Pajamas. It shows you how much thought they put into the game, and I'm sure many people will steal that. You should steal that pistol round there from NIP.
Fifflaren showing his musical side. Oh yeah, hitting that belt, playing a bit of a tune. In the middle of that. It's 11-6 here for Titan. Five rounds ahead. The first one to an eco, as they have lost the anti-eco before to a very successful bombsite B push. Bombsite B now being defended by three CP. One of them actually rotating back to Speedway. Terrace have yet to decide which direction they want to take. Ninjas in Pajamas are not as sure as they were earlier on in the game. Earlier on in the day. Vladimir will get himself a double. There's a good start here as he takes down both Kenny S and Existence on Arch side. They know there's not a lot of people left on in bombsite A. Maximally one. MBK will take down Freiburg at least. And get right, we'll take down Scream. It's on up to Smiths here. We should try and incur at least a bit of damage onto the terrorist side, leading the Seeker. Sadly, he won't, as Forrest will finish him off. So a bread and butter anti-eco here for Ninjas in Pajamas, who will get the seventh round. 11-7, they're actually really closing in the gap with that eco win. It was huge for them, and not very huge for Titan.
It really has a really big impact on the money. It really just very disheveling effect on the economy. And look at this FAMAS buy coming in with quite a few nades for Titan. They're going aggressive down mid. This is what I was talking about before. Titan are known for these kind of innovative plays. And is it working out for them? So far, NIP are just tapping them down and it just didn't work at all. They were playing quite a slow defensive beginnings and they were all there to support one another. And I think they realized Titan's propensity to pull out plays like something like this.
Yeah, exactly. It looks like we have the last man standing. Scream here with the FAMAS.
And the bugged pulp. It's great. It's awesome.
Why is it like that?
I don't know what bug is, but it can be a lot worse than this too. It can be much more slanted. But he gets the first kill onto Exist.
Ooh, double nade here by the T site.
Ouch.
And it will finish him off. Another picked up nade after that. So a triple nade. Flarent finishing off Scream. Not even giving him a chance to come any closer. 11-8, Ninjas in Pajamas, closing the distance. Titan, forced onto a full eco here. We do have a Deagle buy though, and a CZ. Actually, even a P250 on Scream. So it's not as bare bone as we... Quandy was being attempted there by Existence. Down mid, but it really didn't work for him.
Yeah, he gave away the Deagle, I like that. I was just about to suggest that. Give the Deagle away with that low health.
Well, he gave it to Smiths, who lost it almost immediately. Actually, no, he gave it to Kenny S. Sorry. Kenny S. Kenny S has the Deagle. Kenny S rotating towards bombsite B here. He has a bit more health to survive a bit longer with a stronger weapon.
What a
shot there by Kenny S. He's as good as a marksman with his arm as he is with his Deagle, it seems.
With everything, to be honest. Well, he is a monster, isn't he?
He's probably very good with the Negev as well. You just haven't seen that in... professional play. Getting those headshots.
Can you imagine Get Right with the Negev? Oh my god.
That he'd just have perfect spray patterns if he was using an M4.
Yeah. Oh, unfortunate there. Wanted to see the continuation of the Deagle, the One Deagle story. But the One Deagle story is to be cut short here. Either way, it's looking a lot better for NIP right now. Look at this. Forrest is doing the scream. The scream.
Yeah. He is using Scream's own tactics against him. But this is very interesting here. Look at the scores. You can see that Forrest is doing a great job. Him and Exist with 15 kills. But in fact, in the second half of the game, it's Forrest who has been getting the majority of the kills. And he's been the one who's made the main difference for his side.
That Asimov, here it is on Kenny S. And you never know where he's going to be warping from. And he's a really defensive angle here on B. And you can see that this is... You know, they're not going to be expecting so many players here, and they're not going to be expecting Kenny S with an AWP here either. That's the power of this.
But the problem with this angle is that one flash or one smoke is going to render him absolutely useless, and he's going to have to switch. But we have three men here on bombsite B. Kenny S is actually rotating towards A. Better choice since the bomb is going towards that direction. But the bomb is not going to push into the site until they can figure out whether they can push into bombsite B or not. If they get a frag into B, they're probably going to go for the rotation. Kenny S with a support smoke all the way towards bombsite B, and I love those kind of smokes, really. Some technical play here on Inferno by these Counter-Strike geniuses.
Definitely, and I do like how Kenny S moves around the map. We can see, you know, at first, you know, they left the angle on smoke so that it would tempt the terrorists, bait them into peeking the angle, and then they'd find Kenius scoped on them with an AWP, so that would have been nice. But of course, NIP, they're playing this one really, really slow, which is quite nice. I do like that from them. And we can kind of see some action here very shortly. Everyone's going to be coming in. Here they are. Scream turning. Look at that crossfire there.
Oh, beautiful there by Smiths and Scream as they take down three of the incoming terrorists. They stop that. Oh, Scream with a double. Two headshots, one with a wall bang. That's the aim we want to see from this beast. And that's a very good bomb site B defense by Scream and Smith. Scream with a 4K. Excellent play here by the beast himself. The beast from the east, Scream. The Belgian Moroccan showing some really excellent CS there. Now, Ninjas in Pajamas, they can go for a full buy again. And that could have been very disastrous for... Oh, KDS with a shot on Forest. That could have been very disastrous for Titan had they been able to go into the bombsite. And that's the kind of CS you want to see on the bombsite. You have to be able to defend it with some really, really nice spray downs. But KDS is going to get himself the second. Confidence is rising with Titan. Nip Gaming look a little less confident as that smoke's going to make KDS have to change position. Putting that onto Arch side. The bomb is at mid. Flaren will get himself an entry frag on MBK. Truck side. I wonder what the terrorists are going to do now. Kenyas is definitely going to get this kill. There's no doubt about it. He's too fast with the off.
Now this is the third one. And I'm not sure if he's going to be able to get any more. The rest are over at the B-bomb site. Let's have a look. We've got Scream over here. He's with Smiths.
Poor Scream with his bent vision. Don't know how he can get a 4K.
Indeed. It's a sad story. And Smith is here to support him, though. Give him that moral support that he needs. And look at this little hopping there. That's a very nice thing to steal as well if you're a B player. And here we go. They're going to move in. Scream put to the test. He actually goes down, and Smith is there with the support. Gets the trade. Very important. There's the bomb down, and there goes the duel. And Exist pulls the victory there, but it's a short-lived one as Kenny S gets the fourth frag. And this is it with Kenny. Like, let's just look at his movement. First quick kill on mid. Circles all the way around back. To Arch side, gets another frag. Like, the timing is just perfect. Then falls back to another angle. He knows exactly the way to position himself. He's so mobile, always on another angle, and always hard to predict exactly where he is.
Honestly, once you get Scream and Kenny S playing their game, it's really GG. Because you've got Kenny S in bombsite A stopping that push, and you've got Scream in bombsite B stopping the push. And even if Scream goes down, you've got Kenny S rotating to support. So, really, it's a very, very tough situation for Nip at the moment. They're going to have to figure out a way to stop the momentum rising and to stop these players playing such a strong CT side here in the on the Inferno. But, as we saw before,
it was a
good choice there by Ninjas in Pajamas to forsake bombsite A after losing a few of the and then going towards bombsite B. But sadly, they weren't able to plant the bomb in time. It looks like it might be a bombsite A execute here. Smokes and Flash is going to be thrown from mid and second mid. Kenny S and the rest of the crew have to be ready for the action. Kenny S again, holding outside. Didn't know he's going to be holding outside. Fifth Laren trying to see if he could take him. Exist will pick up his off. He's going to go for it as well. Kenny S will take him down one by one. They simply cannot play 1v1 up. You simply cannot go for it against Kenny S. You have to do something different. He'll miss his shot against Forrest though. Yep. I'll give Forrest a few more seconds in his life, but it's... not long before the timer runs out. There's 25 seconds left, and Forrest is the last man standing. He'll get himself a kill on Scream. The bomb is down. It's not going to be very probable here for Forrest to win the round. He's going to try and go for the bomb. Oh, a flash at least. Kenny S with an early shot. A bit too early. Forrest with a third kill. 7 seconds left on the clock. The CTs just have to hide, really, and make sure that he doesn't go towards bombs. But there's no chance he has time. He didn't even pick up the bomb. Well, he's going to keep that AK-47, but that's a very important win for Titan. It will put him on 14 rounds. Now the Ts are in a bit of trouble. Are they going to go for a forced buy, or are they just going to eco and make it so that they can play the 15th round? It is a forced buy here by Ninjas in Pajamas. They have to win this round, because if they don't, they lose this game.
He's in one of those spots, timing-wise, that he gets to be aggressive because he's conditioning them to go, all right, Kenny has AWP on mid. We're not so they're focusing around the rest of the map. So he doesn't ever need to be in mid now because that angle's always going to be clear because they're assuming that he's going to be there. So now he gets to do stuff like this. They're going to maybe peek. There's no smoke there, and that's going to bait them to maybe get a bit of information, maybe like peek and see what's going on. And then that's the last thing they ever see because Kenny has put an AWP bullet in their face. But there is action towards A. Again, the B play didn't work. I was expecting maybe an apartments push. We didn't see it from them yet, but... Here we go. NIP are setting up the push. with a very scrapped together buy here on mid.
There are only two CTs at the moment. Kenny S has to rotate very quickly to support them. If they go in fast and hard, they might be causing a bit of damage. If they win this round, they might have a chance to come back into this game. Flashes are thrown. MBK is ready, and with the help of Existence, we'll be able to take down Exist. Might be his namesake. No, definitely not friends. As Kenny S is going to come on Forest, MBK will take down Fryder again furiously with that P2000 and finish off. Get right, it's 15-9. It looks like it's going to be a map for Titan, as we had presumed earlier on. Full buy here by Ninjas in Pajamas. They will be able to get some AK-47s, perhaps a few Galils. And I think the Inferno is going to go for the Frenchman. This is absolutely excellent play here. They came back from that loss and they rebounded with a lot of confidence. Kenny S and Scream doing a great job. MBK as well.
And they didn't see Kenny S doing this yet, so he can keep doing it. Because the surprise is still there. So this time he's going to get the shot, but misses it. But he does get one. He goes for the re-peek, but his teammates are there to support him. And that is just, I mean, this is just how to play with AWP on this map as the CT arch guy. Like Kenny is showing it to you.
It's such a nasty little play that him and Smith's just decimating three players in almost 10 seconds. No, 5 seconds. It's almost unfair. Ninjas in Pajamas had, you know, they couldn't do much. They really couldn't do much. The AWP is too fast. They get the peeker's advantage. And so, they really use their advantage. Now Smith's with the third kill for him. The bomb's down. Get right, pick it up. And it'll be finished off here by MBK. And it's a map for Titan, 16-9 for the Frenchman. It's going to go to Dust2, as we had presumed earlier on. And this is going to be very interesting, because this is a map where you would presume that perhaps it might be something that Titan will do better at. It might be Titan's game. Titan might be actually kicking out Nip from the tournament.
Yep.
Or maybe with a change of Kenny S with Shox. Maybe that's going to give them a weaker Dust2. Maybe they're going to go back to Very Games days where they weren't playing a very strong Dust2 side. We'll only wait and see. I mean, this is the game that's going to prove it for us. There's nothing else we can say about it. But that game there, for a moment there, Ninjas in Pajamas looked like they were capable of a comeback. But Titan, they held the reins and they went strong on them. And they were able to secure a pretty confident win. And that's going to definitely bolster the confidence for Titan. However, we are going to be showing you the third and final map in this amazing matchup. It's the El Clasico, Titan versus Nip. But for now, there's going to be a quick break. We'll see you very, very soon.